I'm no media historian, but I do know that horror comics go way back. Folks have loved these scariest stories done up in panels and pages for as long as they've been available, probably longer. Back in the day, kids would snag whatever looked spooky and ravenously devour every gory and gruesome twist of fate with aplomb. But the thing is, people know what sells, and over time a lot of horror comics were made. Some good and some not so good. Thankfully, these days we all have the ability to screen our intake and find the best scares from the folks with the best scares on the brain. So let's toss the lesser horror comics by the wayside and talk about some that are worth every penny. Hello everyone and welcome back to Top 10 Nerd. I'm your host for the day, Keegan Hughes, and today we're gonna be counting down the top 10 shocking horror comics you need to read. Some classics, some contemporary hits. Covering a lot of ground here. If you want to keep the good times rolling, make sure to check out our most popular videos playlist right over here. Excellent, let's get started. Coming in at number 10, we've got Tales from the Crypt. And why not start with a bona fide classic? Sure, most folks know it from the TV show now, but it all originated with the comic. Throughout the 50s, EC Comics put out all sorts of horror anthology comics, with tales about as varied as you'd expect. Credited along other horror classics like Eerie and Creepy with bringing comics back from the brink after World War II, Tales from the Crypt effectively used horror to captivate audiences all over the place. Most folks associate Tales with the one and only Crypt Keeper, especially those who were introduced to the series through the TV show. But in the original run of comics, there were three figures introducing us to macabre tales, each with their own unique personality and distaste for the other hosts. So many classic horror stories are packed into Tales from the Crypt, and that's not even taking into account how forward-thinking they were. Like all good horror, Tales takes shots at the establishment in the status quo, questioning why things are the way they are. While maybe a little outdated, this is a classic comic that set the standard for things to come. Coming in at number 9, we've got Fatale. Now for something a little newer. Ed Brubaker and Sean Phillips' Fatale. This is a wild postmodern crossover involving all sorts of awesome horror stuff. First, we've got the noir elements. Seedy criminal underbelly, lots of shadows, and a femme fatale protagonist. Then we've got some Lovecraftian intrigue folded in. And of course, it's all done up in a 50s style, adding to the timeless feel of it all. We follow Jo, a seemingly immortal woman who's been chased for decades by a Lovecraftian cult. Jo has the power to make men fall irreversibly in love with her, whether or not she wants that to happen. Usually the men that fall for this femme fatale also put their lives on the line for her and end up dying in terrifying and grotesque ways. It's the classic noir story told from a different angle. Femme fatale has man fall for her, feels bad, and then witnesses his demise. The eldritch themes are strong within the world of fatale, and some of these scares are downright disturbing. The tone and feel of it is something special for sure. Check it out if you like throwbacks, film noir, or horror. It's sure to impress on all counts. Coming in at number 8, we've got Gideon Falls. Part Twin Peaks, part word-of-mouth creepypasta, Gideon Falls feels like something totally new and crazy. Put together by Jeff Lemire and Andrea Sorrentino, this is a horror story driven by the exploration of evil rather than gore and gristle. We meet Norton Sinclair, an amalgam of the worst parts of Lemire and Sorrentino, as he explores the urban legend of the Black Barn. This structure pops up throughout time and space in order to foretell death and destruction, madness and mayhem. Of course, that's only the first story. This continuing comic will keep going up until December with new information, but then it shall wrap up. There's plenty of catching up to do though, so get on it quick. Just be prepared to feel the terror flow through you. Coming in at number 7, we've got The Walking Dead. What kind of essential reads list would this be without the horror comic that defined the last decade and beyond? Sure, the TV show and resultant spin-offs probably have a bigger audience at this point, but the comics are what got everything started. The Walking Dead is the ultimate modern zombie franchise. There are graphic novels, there are novelizations, there are video games, and they all tell compelling stories of people trying to live during a zombie apocalypse. The terror and mayhem of the initial outbreak are usually glossed over, and The Walking Dead instead opts to look at how human beings attempt to retain some semblance of real life among the chaos. The zombies themselves, while gross, disfigured, and dangerous, aren't the scariest bit by a long shot. Although Tony Moore's art style definitely sells the terror they're supposed to give off. But in the world of The Walking Dead, the zombies are pretty easy to deal with if you're able to stick to a plan. Not all people can though, and a lot of the time the deepest terror comes from how people deal with the post-apocalyptic world. Humans are capable of some truly messed up things, and this is explored in depth. In addition to being wildly popular, The Walking Dead is also long running. So if you're looking for someone to really take you on a journey, maybe give it a go. Coming in at number 6, we've got Nameless. Grant Morrison writes some archaic, bleak, and hard to stomach comics, which is exactly why I'm recommending you read Nameless. It's a tale of body horror and humanity's failures. Likened by some to the works of Clive Barker and David Cronenberg, it's a nightmare on a whole other level. In it, a crew of astronauts end up crossing crossing paths with God, like the one and only in this case. And instead of being a benevolent, loving, caring figure, God just decides it's time to crank up that despair. And with despair comes all sorts of technicolor blood and gore. Gigantic maws open up to swallow folks, endless eyes constantly watching. It's a disturbing and lasting tale, one that will confuse and cause pain. Coming in at number 5, we've got The Sandman. Neil Gaiman is a name that most folks watching are probably already familiar with. And if you're not, don't worry, he's got such a wide range of stories to consume, I'm sure you'll come across him somewhere else very soon. The Sandman is one of the most critically acclaimed comics of all time. It is the tale of Dream, the human form of all dreams and tales. He's imprisoned by some occultists by decades and eventually manages to escape. From here, he's able to fly around the universe, ensuring that all of the dreaming business he's been entrusted with is taken care of. There have been all sorts of genre spins throughout the series, but one that sticks out to most folks is the story known as 24 Hours. A lunatic by the name of Dr. Destiny gets a hold of a magical ruby, which he uses to control the minds of everyone in a 24-hour diner. He makes them confess their darkest secrets, and believe me, some of these are dark, and then has them torture each other to death. Teeth, skewers in the eyes, and more. Gaiman likes to work with the idea of stories eventually ending in death, as every life does, and while this disturbs some readers, others appreciate it for what it is. Up to you, I suppose. Coming in at number 4, we've got Preacher, another big name. We've got Garth Ennis and Steve Dillon at the helm, putting together a fascinating and shocking tale of life, death, and often revenge. There are so many disturbing moments throughout the series, like it literally kicks off with a church chock full of people burning to the ground. All the folks inside burn too. Talk about a hot start. From there, it only gets crazier, introducing all sorts of perverted, bloodthirsty, and generally up antagonists at every turn. If you got through an issue of Preacher without meeting someone that made your skin crawl, probably reading the wrong thing. Double check that cover, will ya? Coming in at number 3, we've got Lock and Key. Following the violent murder of their father, a trio of siblings ends up at the ancient family home, the Key House. The place is full of, you guessed it, keys. But these keys are special, magical things. They open up possibilities rather than doors. Some lead to other dimensions, others cause changes in the person using them. And of course, all of this leads to the discovery of a creepy mystery. It's been recently adapted into a series by Netflix, but that has some mixed reviews. So if you want the real experience, pick up the first volume and get to page turning. Coming in at number 2, we've got Alan Moore's Swamp Thing. Swamp Thing is a legendary creature with all sorts of different adaptations. Wes Craven did a Swamp Thing. Swamp Thing was brought back recently as a series, and of course, Alan Moore, comic genius, did his version of it. To most, this is the definitive version of Swamp Thing, a hulking, decomposing mass of plant and man. Swamp Thing constantly wrestles with his own humanity, or what's left of it anyways. And while there are plenty of monsters and fights and rotten pieces of flesh, the scariest moments don't come from the bombastic. They come from the realm of the psychological. You have to read it to get it. And finally, at number 1, we've got Nailbiter. Let me break this one down for you real quick. Nailbiter is a story set in Buckaroo, Oregon. The classic small town, perfect for a serial killer to run rampant. Or serial killers, in this case. 16 of the most prolific killers known to man were born in Buckaroo, and Nailbiter takes a look at the newest. Edward Warren, also known as Nailbiter, loves to look out for people with a tendency to bite their nails. Then he kidnaps them, waits for the nails to grow back, and chews their fingers until he reaches bone. Yum. This is a story about a lunatic who just keeps getting away with crimes. No ghosts, ghouls, goblins, or eldritch monstrosities. Maybe that's what makes it so scary. Holy moly, that's a lot of scary comments. Good thing it's October, now go and cozy up by the fire and start reading. What'd you think of the list? Do you agree with my selections? Are there any that I missed? What's the most shocking horror comic you've ever read? Make sure you let me know down in the comments. Speaking of comments, let's take a look at some of your more nutritious ones from the top 10 creepiest supervillains. Doggo Incorporated says, of course you had to release this at night. Well, when else? We're going for maximum creep factor. John Burt says, the Joker, am I a joke to you? Yes! Isn't that what you wanted all along? And More OW says, I am happiest after a nightmare. It always reminds me how good in reality life is. That's an interesting way of looking at it. I tend to be sweatiest after a nightmare. And that's all the time we have for today. Before I get caught up in a fight between some supers, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe for more creepy comics. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. My gross soft word, baby. Oh man. I'm just gonna wait for this siren. I feel like it's about to get louder. Introduced to the series through the TV show. Wow, it did get louder. Do you think that's fine? Should I just keep going? A 50s style, adding to the timeless feel it all. Feel a bit dull. Whoa. Usually the men that fall as he explores.